two occasions, Jesus uses the phrase, the hour cometh, and now is. The hour cometh, and now is. One instance where he uses this phrase, when he spoke about the resurrection from the dead. In John chapter 5, verse 25, he says, verily, verily, I say unto you, the hour is coming, and now is, when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and they that hear will live. Praise God. Now these are words of Jesus well over 2,000 years ago. And right there and then, Jesus Christ was saying, now is. Now is the time. Now is the moment. The hour has come. The appointed time has come to hear the voice of the Son of God and return back to life. Praise God. He says that those who are asleep in their graves will hear this voice and awake into life. Praise God. Another instance where Jesus Christ uses this phrase, the hour cometh and now is in John chapter 4, verse 23, when he met with the Samaritan woman by the side of the well. And these are the words of Jesus. But the hour cometh, I'm reading John chapter 4, verse 23. The hour cometh and now is, when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Now I want you to underline the words in John chapter 4, verse 23. Jesus Christ repeats this same statement, this same phrase, the hour cometh and now is. This is the words of Jesus recorded well over 2,000 years ago. The hour cometh and now is. Brethren, there's something wrong in the way religion has put or presented the words of this Bible to us. Because Jesus Christ seems to be indicating something that is occurring right now, presently. You see, we've had so many books on the shelves over the years, so many writings and so many prophecies, and people keep speaking of a future event, a future resurrection, not understanding that now is the time to hear the voice of truth, hear the voice of the Spirit. Now is the time to ascend back into spirit. Now is the time to worship. Now is the time for the sons of God to awaken back, arise and shine. For your light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen. It is now as you hear the voice of truth. Praise God. And this voice that speaks in this hour has one sole intention, and that is to awaken you back to your senses. Awaken you back to your true original state in God. Because if any man is dead or asleep, it means that he was once awoken or once awakened. It means that he was once alive. Before you die, it means that you are once alive. We know that all men receive that knockout blow and enter into, we can call it a subconscious, you know, state. Unconscious spiritual state, a state of death. Have you seen somebody in a coma? When you see a man in a coma, you are actually looking at how people are in this world. They are, you know, spiritually dead. See, you are dead when you do not understand your true nature as Son of God. You are dead when you do not know your origin in God. You are dead when you don't understand your true spiritual form in God from the beginning. Praise God. And when a man walks ignorantly of the truth, he suffers tribulation, he suffers many hurts. See, he's put under the forces of darkness, where corruption reigns over him, where fear and torment, and where all the curses that we see in humanity, you know, have a hold on him. You see, but the hour comes, and now is, where men begin to hear the voice of reasoning, wherever they are. Praise God. They begin to hear the voice of God the Father reminding them of their true state. And right where you are, as you remember, as you get a hold of this mystery, begin to walk in the reality of the Son of God. Now is the moment. It's not tomorrow when you put on wings. It's not tomorrow when somebody appears in the sky with a trumpet. Now is the moment for your rapture. Now is the moment for your resurrection. Now is the moment for awakening. See, hear this voice of reasoning. Hear the voice of the Alpha and the Omega as he reminds you of your origin in him. Hear that thundering voice. And as you hear that voice, don't be hardened with unbelief. Believe this voice. Align yourself with this voice. And allow this voice to lead you into your rest. So this is the hope of many generations. This is the hope and the joy of all ages. Hallelujah. Praise God. Your hope to enter your rest is your ability to hear this voice today, now. While it is now, hear this voice and walk in this voice. Praise God. Hallelujah. You see, in the book of Hebrews, Paul says in Hebrews chapter 3 that while it is today, meaning while it is now, if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts. I just read Hebrews chapter 3 from verse 7. While it is today, if you hear his voice, while it is now, don't harden your voice. Don't harden your heart, sorry. See, don't be unbelieving. See, don't let beliefs of men and prophecies of men obscure the reality of the indwelling Son of God in you. Don't let evidences around you, don't let, you know, problems in the family, in the body, in your finances, in your emotions, don't let those things choke up this revelation that you are hearing today. Allow this revelation lead you, guide you into the truth. Praise God. We can see that most of the ancients could not enter into the promise. And many today do not enter into the promise because they do not believe. They are able to receive these words, unable to hear this voice and align themselves with this voice. Praise God. Every man must trust this voice. Every man must trust the Father. Praise God. And believe this glad tidings that has been announced through the Son. It has been announced so that every man can once more partake of the glory of the only begotten of the Father. Praise God, we have heard this voice and we are admonished to lay hold on it with all of our hearts, with all of our souls, with all of our strength. Continue in this word. Awake into this word. Strive for eternal life. Let your confession be that I am the Christ, the Son of God. Confess the life of the Christ who is from eternity, whose kingdom is not of this world, who is from a celestial kingdom lifted above all. Confess that life. Live that life by faith. Increase in that life right now, wherever you are, as you hear the voice. The light has come. It has risen upon you. And your hour has come to walk in the reality of the Son of God. Walk this walk by faith. Stand up wherever you are and walk this walk by faith. And you behold a new heaven and a new earth all before your very face. God bless you. Amen.